a sad one. On the other side, yeah, on the more bleak side of what's happening with COVID, RIP to Nick Cordero. The Broadway actor unfortunately passed away from complications due to COVID-19. Again, it's a pretty sad story. I was sort of following this from the outside, and I never really heard of the dude prior to his positive test for COVID. But he was one of the first sort of like high profile people outside of the Tom Hanks and Idris Elbas that kind of got it. And unfortunately, his symptoms just kept getting worse and worse. It got to a point where he had to have his leg amputated. You know, just kind of so terrible to hear. Then you heard about his double lung transplant was going to happen. And now, unfortunately, he died through complications of it. He's only 41 years of age, man. And it's just a real bummer, really, isn't it, to see the different sort of effects and it has on different people. It can sort of spring up on, you know, you hear of sort of like bus drivers getting it and essentially getting spat upon or coughed on by some random person in the street, and then they're passing away. Somebody getting coughed on in the shop and nothing happening. Somebody getting it, not knowing where they got it from, and then suddenly passing away, quickly deteriorating. And then you get this story where essentially he was, you know, in a medically induced coma for the best part of more than 2 months, I think. But man, RIP to Nick Cordero, and you know, thoughts and feelings go to his family. But this is a story from The Hollywood Reporter. It says the following: he received a Tony nomination for Bullets Over Broadway and starred in Waitress and Bronx Tale and musical Rock of Legends, Rock of Ages, sorry. Nick Cordero, the charming Tony-nominated actor known for his work in Bullets Over Broadway, Waitress and the Bronx Tale, died Sunday after a grueling battle with coronavirus. His wife announced he was 41. Since being diagnosed with what was thought to be a pneumonia in late March, the Canadian actor spent weeks in intensive care at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles, had his right leg amputated and lost more than 60 pounds, was hoping to receive a double lung transplant. Like, God almighty. Cordero had come to LA to star at the Bourbon Room owner Dennis Dupree in an immersive adaptation of the long-running Broadway hit Rock of Ages in a new space in the Hollywood Boulevard. He had played the role years ago in a national tour in Broadway, and a new version of the musical opened in January. Survivors include his wife, fitness instructor, and former Broadway dancer Amanda Klotz, who chronicled his health struggles on social media, and their son Elvis, born on June 2019. Mamma mia, a one-year-old. A GoFundMe page has been set up to help the family. God has another angel in heaven. Now, Klotz on Instagram: my daily husband, my darling husband, passed away this morning. He was surrounded by love. He's surrounded in love by his family, singing and praying as he gently left this earth. She said, "I'm in disbelief and hurting everywhere. My heart is broken, and I cannot imagine our lives without him. Nick was such a bright light. He was such everyone's friend, loved to listen, help, and especially talk. He was incredible actor and musician. He loved his family and loved being a father and a husband. Elvis and I will miss him everything we do every day." Bloody hell. In 2014, Cordero received a Tony nomination and a Theatre World Award for his tap dancing turn as a ghostwriting crook, Cheech in the musical adaptation of Woody Allen's Bullets Over Broadway. Chaz Palminteri, and earned the Oscar nom for his performance as Cheetah. Bloody hell, man. So yeah, RIP, man. And again, just a reminder of just how serious of an issue this is, isn't it? Obviously, you don't need a celebrity to die to be reminded of it, but I think with places being eased in, with the lockdown being eased in some places and things sort of going well in different sort of countries, you can be forgiven to be a little bit lax and talk, take your foot off the pedal. But especially for Americans who have just, they're in plain denial about what's going on, and this should be a wake-up call to really sort of like pay attention, because for however serious a disease is, for however serious the virus is, it is easily avoidable for the most part, right? Staying in place, avoiding, you know, crowded rooms and spaces, wearing the face mask if you have to go out, washing your hands, all that kind of basic stuff, keeping distance, essentially can allow you to avoid this virus for the most part. So if you can do that, then why not? Do you know what I mean? It's not, it'd be worse if it was. We'd be in a far different, difficult situation. We'd be in a far worse position now if the virus was, you know, way more aggressive. It is still aggressive, but in a way that it spreads, right? If you avoid those things that I mentioned, you're usually going to be okay. So to have a whole country such as America have some people in the population who are still sort of on the fence about the severity of the issue is just, it's just sad to see in general, and it's just so sad to see. But yeah, RIP to Nick Cordero. Again, thoughts and prayers go out to his family and friends and anyone that knew him. Again, I followed the story from the onset when I sort of heard about what was going on, just as a sort of case study and issue. I was kind of hoping and praying that he'd pull through, but unfortunately didn't. Hopefully, because it's such a public case, people will come forward and be able to, you know, contribute to the GoFundMe, support his family any way they can. That's the most we can do, really, because we're all kind of going through the same sort of mess up situation, and you can only hope that it gets better for people going forward now, and that these people that are passing away sort of act as a cautionary tale and are sort of able to be used as a case study to help people maybe later on down the line. That's the most you can aim for it, and as a silver lining, that's the most you can hope for. But yeah, RIP Nick Cordero, man. RIP.